Yeah. So good afternoon, everyone. So today I would like to discuss the subject of cost benefit analysis. So I hope now you are able to see this paper, techno-economic analysis of off-grid rooftop solar PV system. This is a paper written by a couple of BTech students from 2012 batch. So slightly your senior batch students, but then this is very simple paper written by BTech students, so it is not very difficult for anybody to understand. So let's look at this. See, sometime back I was showing you a lot of examples where rooftop solar systems have been installed by several residential household people and getting a lot of benefit from it. So, sorry. So here also, we have done some analysis. But this is quite old. I mean, this is 4 or 5 years old paper. So right now, the cost benefit analysis means we have taken the cost of panels, etc., existing at 4 years back, 5 years back. Still, it was viable. Now the costs have further reduced. So let me just explain you how to do cost benefit analysis. Okay, for a rooftop solar system, it is very simple. Just look at this diagram in page one. So we have these parts, right? So there is a PV panel. So PV panel and it has a charge controller, and then there is a battery. See, sometimes you can have without battery system, or sometimes you can have with battery also. So it depends on the your choice. See, if you don't consider battery, that means the battery cost will be zero and that's it. So otherwise you can consider battery and you can have some storage. Then there is a DC to AC inverter, which converts the DC energy into AC. And then there is your home, and your home has different loads. Now, what is the cost of this system? So there are, broadly speaking, there are four parts here. So one is the panel. And the next one is the charge controller. And next one is the battery. And next one is the inverter. So if you take the cost of these four systems, then the total cost of the system you can estimate. Okay? So that is the idea. So I'll just directly go to equation number 7. So can you see this equation number 7? This is cost of the PV system. The cost of PV system is nothing but cost of the panel plus cost of the battery plus cost of the inverter, plus cost of the charge controller. So very basic. See, there might be much more advanced studies, but then this is very, very basic study. So obviously these four costs are there. The diagram which I showed, it has these four parts, panel, battery, remember the diagram. So if you want, once again, I'll show you that diagram. So have a look at this diagram. It has one is the PV panel, two is the charge controller, three is the battery, and four is the inverter. So if I add the cost of these four, the total cost will be calculated. So now my first question is, how to estimate the cost of the panel? Okay, so any suggestions? How do we know the cost of the panel? So obviously, if I go to any online website, okay, so cost of PV panel. So here you can see a lot of panels are coming into picture. So let me simply open one example. See, there are again hundreds of companies, but then randomly I just opened one example. So so here you can see cost also is displayed here. So. So there are several examples you will find. See, there is again, when I went to the Startup Hour website, there are ready-made solutions available. Solution one is like this, solution 2, 3, 4, 5, and solution 6. So there are number of solutions and number of this thing. And then under off-grid system also, there are several this thing. So you can find out. So anyway, so can you suggest how do we find the cost of a system?
Excuse me, sir. Sir, I have sent one message. It has a link. It has a proper estimation how to calculate the rooftop solar PV system cost. Can you just go through that link? It has like proper calculation, including subsidies and everything.
Okay.
Yeah.
So let me check that link. So this looks like I'm just opening the link. So how much does a rooftop PV system cost? So by the way, how many of you know how to do this calculation? Okay. So since you are doing a course on smart grid, definitely you should be knowing about how much it will cost or how to do this cost benefit analysis. That's why this session. Okay. So so some examples they are given here. So solar module is 32 rupees per watt. Okay, inverter is 6 to 12 rupees per watt. And cable is 1 to 2 rupees per watt, and the structure is about 5 rupees per watt, and then peripherals and everything. So, so even if you take the maximum of all this, see for example here 35. So I hope you are able to see this. 35 plus let's take it round off to 10, so 45, and then this round off to 2, 47, and then 5, 53, 55. So around 60. 60. Rupees per watt. Okay. So for 1 watt cost you 60 rupees, 100 watt cost 6,000 rupees, and 1 kilowatt cost 60,000 rupees. So approximately this is the cost. Okay. Yeah. So so is this what you are telling? Yeah, exactly. That's what 100 kilowatt system will cost 6 lakh rupees, right? I'm sorry. 100 kilowatt is costing 60 lakh rupees. So that is one side. Okay. So what about the benefit? So in cost benefit analysis, you have to do cost analysis and you have to do benefit analysis, right? So what is the benefit then? So I'm just opening one Excel sheet for your benefit. So let me see. Cost per watt. Okay. So some website is showing the cost per watt to be 60. Okay. So this is in rupees per, this is in rupees. So now capacity. So let's say 10 kilowatt, capacity in kilowatts. So PV system cost. So how will you find the cost? So this is in kilowatts, so multiply by 1000, again multiply by the cost. So we'll get the some cost like this. So let me give some currency format. Okay, so here you are able to see 60,000 rupees for a 10 kilowatt system. Is it correct?
Yes, sir.
Or is it? Sorry, I think 6 lakh rupees, sorry. 1 kilowatt system is 60,000. So a 10 kilowatt system is 6 lakh. Okay. Now this is a cost. So what about benefit? So let me keep the cost in orange color or some shade of red color. So how do we calculate the benefit? So let's calculate the benefit. So energy per day. So how can you calculate energy per day? See, thumb rule is if you have a 1 kilowatt system, it will generate 5 units. Okay? So that will be simply multiplied by 5. Okay, so you can generate 50 units per day. Okay, so cost, sorry, grid price. So what is the grid price? What is the grid price? Can you suggest any price?
So 6 rupees for residential average.
Price of 1 unit of?
Yes, sir, for one.
How much?
6 rupees.
6 rupees? Okay. So let's say the grid price is 6 rupees. So saving per day. So 50 units multiplied by 6 rupees. So your saving per day is 300 rupees, right? Now, saving per year? Multiplied by 365. Okay. So 1,09,000 rupees. Okay. So payback. So payback period will be whatever initial cost divided by yearly saving. So about 5.5 years, right? So it's a simple calculation. So what is the lifetime of a solar panel? Can anybody guess what is the lifetime of a solar panel?
25 years.
So even if you take even if you take 10 years, so first 5 years you have to bear the cost, then remaining 5 years at least it will be free. So that is the reason everybody is going for a solar district. So by the way, 50 kilowatt hour, right? See, for a typical household, what is the consumption for a typical household? Can anybody, see, a lot of you are in your houses, right? How many units do you have monthly?
Sir, average it is 250 units.
Monthly on consumption.
Yes,
so monthly consumption for a typical household, for a somebody saying 250. So if it is 250, then you don't have to invest in 10 kilowatt capacity, right? So how much kilowatt would be sufficient?
So 1.2 kilowatt will be sufficient.
So if I take 1 kilowatt, you are generating. Okay, so this will be, I'll just say monthly consumption, right? I'll calculate daily consumption. So the monthly consumption divided by 30. So about 10 units per day, 8.33. So you need 10 units per day. So let's go for a 2 kilowatt system. So if I go for a 2 kilowatt system, so I'm generating 10 units per day, and I'm able to easily support 300 units in a month, and then I can generate, I can easily meet my demand, right? So, but look at the cost, 1.2 lakh, okay? So what is the cost of a house? Typically, what is the cost of the house?
40 lakhs.
So typical cost of the house, how much is it?
Between 40 to 50 lakhs.
So let's take 50 lakhs. Okay, so it looks like this is 50 lakh. So even if you take 1% of it, how much will it be? 0.01. Okay, so 1% is 50,000. 2%, let's say, about 1 lakh. Okay, so compared to the cost of the house, cost of the rooftop solar panel is very less, 1 or 2%, but that will save you energy cost for a long duration. Yes, so that is what you need to understand. Just a minute. Hello. Hello. Can anybody speak? I just want to check my audio.
Yes, sir. It is audible. Yes,
yeah. So.
Okay, so let's continue. Does this convince you that everybody is going to have a rooftop solar in future? Is there any reason for houses not going for rooftop solar?
Investment wise benefit analysis, but for solar PV system to adopt, we should go for this system.
I'm sorry, your voice was not clear. Can you? What is it? Can you repeat to whoever was speaking? Anyway, so there was one question. Can we go 100% solar? Okay, so this is what I am showing here, right? If your monthly consumption is 250 units, then you install 2 kW solar panel, and then it will cost you 1.2 lakh approximately. And then your payback period is 5.5 years, and you can completely supply your energy. Okay. Let's do a little bit more of detailed analysis. So here, first thing what you have to do is do the load analysis. Okay, what is your load? So here you see, I have already prepared a simple Excel sheet. Okay. So lights, okay, 15 lights and all these things. Let me include the consumption. So what is the consumption? Number of devices multiplied by power rating of the device multiplied by hours of operation, and I'll divide by 1000 to get the consumption in kilowatt hours, right? So total. So 24.8 you are getting, okay? So shall we play around with these numbers, right? So let's wait for one of the members. So can somebody give a rough estimate? One of you, I require one of you to volunteer. So how many lights do you have in your house? Anybody? We need not what exact numbers, just approximate numbers.
10 lights, sir.
Lights do you have in your house?
Nearly 10 lights.
Okay, so there are 10 lights. Probably we underestimate and count, it may be more. So I'll take 20 lights just for this thing. And what is the wattage of each light? What is the wattage of each light approximately?
9 watt LED, sir.
Yes, 9, 10 watt.
What?
9 watt LED, sir.
10 watts?
Yes, sir.
80. Okay. And operation? How many hours do you operate?
12 hours.
Okay, so 12 hours. Next, what about fans? How many fans should I take? I need quick answers from one of you. I think maybe Faniram can.
Six fans. Yes, sir.
And what about wattage? Okay, six. What about wattage? I'm just editing.
Six.
What is
60 watts? So then number hours of operation.
Twelve hours we can take. Okay, twelve hours.
What about AC?
AC 2. Yes, sir. Two ACs for
Shall
two
I
bedroom
it as it is?
House. Two ACs okay. We can take, sir.
So two ACs and each one is what's 1 ton AC.
Hmm.
And 10 hours, is that okay?
Yes, sir. Hmm.
Okay, so one TV I'm taking, and what is the wattage of TV?
Thirty watts.
So let's take 40 watts, sir. TV. Then yes, hours of operation. Hours of operation.
10 hours we can take.
This kind of exercise, everybody. Huh?
Yes, sir.
Ten hours
we'll take, sir.
Okay, washing machine one.
Hmm.
Okay. What is the rating machine?
150, 100 watts or 150 watts, I think.
So let's take 150 watts and 2 hours.
Hmm.
Okay.
Hmm.
And geyser. So one geyser and the power be something like
1000 watts.
Fine. And okay, you want okay, and then and if you have geyser, you heater, computers.
One computer.
Let's take 60 watt and then 2 hours because you are charging through your laptop. So yes. Fridge, one fridge, and so what is the wattage of a fridge?
200 watts, maybe, sir. 100 to 200 watts.
200 watts. So, projector. So, casual things, so students were suggesting a lot of things. So, we'll leave it up. Or maybe we'll just make zero. So that the total becomes about 50. Okay. So, this is how you estimate. How much of energy you require per day, you estimate like this. Did everybody understand how we did this?
Yes, sir.
So in the earlier example, energy per day was only 10 units, right? So that monthly bill was, daily consumption was only 8 units and the monthly bill was 250 units. But now in this example, our daily consumption is about 50 units, which is very high. Actually, this is 50 units is quite high because we are given very high numbers. In our house itself, in the where I am staying, I'm consuming about 10 units per day. Okay, so 50 units per day is quite huge, but it's okay. So just for the matter of estimation. Now here you see total 50 units per day. Okay, therefore, total power, how much panels are required? So how do we get this, the number of panels? So that formula is given in this paper. So here, so let's look at the equation number one. Okay, equation number one, U is the number of devices, P is the power of the device, and N is the number of hours it is operating. And then summation over, just now we did this formula, right? Energy per day you are calculating. Any doubts about this equation? U is the number of devices, P is the power of rating, and N is the number of hours. You product all these three, divide by 1000 to convert into kilowatt hours, and then the total will be nothing but the energy consumed per day. Is that okay? Now, average hours of sunshine and D rating factor. Okay, so See, your energy per day divide the total power output of PV should be energy per day divided by average sun and then derating factor. Okay. So typically the values are like this: 7 hours of sun and 80% derating factor. So from that we can calculate the power rating, that is PPV. PPV is the total number of PV panels. Sorry, PPV is the power rating. So here, if you see the formula, so here you can see hours of sunlight is taken as 8 hours. Let me go to the right. And then efficiency of the solar system taken as 80%. So based on that, you can calculate 7.8 kilowatt of the capacity is needed. Therefore, each panel is 200 watts. So therefore, 40 panels are needed. And the cost of solar panels is 3,90,000 total. So these are simple calculations, right? So if I go back, see, number of panels is nothing but total power divided by power per each panel. Okay? So that is number of panel. And then the cost will be nothing but panel cost multiplied by this thing. So panel cost we calculated. Similarly, number of batteries. Okay? So number of batteries is nothing but energy stored per day multiplied by number of days you want the storage, and then this one capacity of the battery, and then depth of discharge of the battery. So that will give you the number of batteries. So 50.26 energy. So if you want 2 days backup, then 100.52 is the this one. Number of batteries 84, and the cost of battery will be 8,40,000. So total connected load we have, inverter output we have, and cost of inverter is 22,000, and cost of charge controller 5,000. This is a fixed cost. Charge controller is an electronic device. And total cost of the system, 14,62,000 rupees. And there is a government subsidy of, I think, 30%. So if you take the government subsidy, then you will get the cost will be only 10 lakhs. Then energy bill saved, electricity bill saved for, per year is also almost like that. So payback period here is coming to be 7 years. So this was because this calculation was done in 2016. Those times the cost were a little high. Now 2020 the cost is even reduced. So now the payback period is only 5 years. So did you, like, if you go through this paper, if you read this paper and if you understand the calculation, then easily we can do this kind of cost benefit analysis. Okay, so that is the purpose of this thing. So let me once again quickly show you this illustrative example. So here you can see illustrative example. Two illustrative examples are mentioned. One is the typical household and the other is a typical student hostel building. Okay. So the technical economical analysis, everything is done. So the price of 12 volt 220 ampere hour battery considered to be 12,000 rupees. Okay, so this price is as of 2016. Now the price might have reduced. Okay, let us quickly check what is the present price. Okay. 12 volt 220 battery cost. Okay, this is not coming in rupees. So here it is showing 20, but this might be a different listing. So yeah, Sushant is saying approximately 15,000. So more or less similar cost we are having. then the price of 250 watt solar panel is 13,000, it is considered. Then the price of inverter considered 7.4 rupees per watt. Now this inverter price also reduced. Then the price of charge controller is 4,500. So based on this, see, total energy consumption per day, 9.57 or approximately 10 units per day. So power rating about 1.7 or 2 kilowatt you can take. Then number of panels, 7 panels are required. Then cost of panel is 13,000. So total cost is 91,700 rupees. This is the cost A. Okay. Now going down batteries, number of batteries for 3 days backup. So normally we keep 1 day backup, but I'm considering 3 days backup. 22 batteries are needed. And the battery cost is 2,64,000. So this is the battery cost. Then charge controller directly 4,500 is that. And the inverter. So inverter capacity is 600 watts capacity. So the inverter cost comes to 4,000 rupees. So total cost A plus B plus C plus D, the four parts. So 3,64,000. Now subsidy of 40% according to the government subsidy. So the effective cost will be 2,18,000. And total electricity bill for 25 years without using solar power at 6 rupees per unit is 5,23,000. Okay, so in 25 years, the saving is made is 3,00,000. Okay, so if you consider 25 years as lifetime. Now CO2 emission reduction also we calculated, 71.6 tons of CO2 emission reduction. And the payback period is 10.5 years. But right now, because of the reduction in the cost, the payback period will be even less. In fact, if you take only 1 day battery backup, payback period will be even less. Okay, so I have taken 3 days battery backup, so that's why 10 years it is coming. So similarly, you go through this typical hostel building. So same calculation. So these are actual hostels in our campus. So 192 fans, 192, because each hostel building, 6 floors building has 192 rooms. So 192 fans, 192 lights, 4 washing machines, 192 computers, 6 fridges, 2 televisions and other loads, which operated 12, 8, 20, so this many hours. So total consumption per day, I found to be 600 units per day, okay, for the entire hostel block. So based on that, about 107 kilowatt is the rating of the PV panel. Then based on that, around 429 panels are required. So now the question comes, is there any place for keeping the 429 PV panels? And the answer is yes. We measured the building rooftop area, and the rooftop area is such that we can accommodate 400 panels on top of the rooftop building. Okay? So this is possible. Then the cost of panel is 56,00,000. Okay. And number of batteries required for, again, 3 days backup. So here again, if I keep only 1 day backup, even half day backup also some people keep, so the cost will be even less. But anyway, 1,63,00,000 is the cost of batteries. So then charge controller is exactly same, and inverter will be 35 kilowatt inverter. And for that inverter, the cost is 2.5 lakhs about. And the total cost comes to 2,22,00,000 rupees for the this thing. And now we consider subsidy of 40%. Then 1,33,00,000 is the cost. I hope you are following. So then again, coming back to total electricity bill saving. So for 25 years at 6 rupees. By the way, will the price be constant 6 rupees for next 25 years? So obviously not. As every year the price keeps on increasing, and definitely after 10 years, after 15 years, definitely the cost will be more than 6 rupees. But I'm just considering conservatively to be 6 rupees only. Still it is 3,28,00,000 rupees. So now if I calculate the total profit, comes to around 1,94,00,000 or close to 2 crore profit, and 4,490 tons of CO2 emission reduction, and then payback period is of 10 years. Okay, so these are the basic assumptions. So, and finally, these are the observations. So definitely there is a strong case for going for rooftop solar systems, okay, with battery storage. That too. Okay. So I will leave the link of this paper in the description. So you can always download this paper. It's a IEEE ICPS conference paper. You can download this paper and read. So any questions based on this? Are you all convinced that rooftop solar is cost effective? The proof is, first of all, this calculation which I showed right now. And another proof is there are hundreds of videos on YouTube. Everybody all over India are installing rooftop PV systems. And all the components are easily available. There are several companies which are ready to install rooftop solar on your house. So you yourself on your house also, you can make a small this thing, what you call cost benefit analysis, and you also decide and you can go for rooftop PV system. Yeah, so one of the Sushant was mentioning about land cost. Okay, of course, if you go for rooftop PV system, then the land cost will not be added. But then if you want to install PV system on a separate land, then of course the land cost you have to add. And more than the cost of the panel, land cost is becoming more dominant now. But anyway, so that is a strong case for rooftop PV panel. So this is the paper title. You can see techno-economic analysis of off-grid rooftop PV system. You can download and read this paper. Yeah. So any questions, any doubts? Okay, so if you don't have any doubts, then I'll end this class here and we'll meet again in the next class in the coming Tuesday. Okay. There is one question. Problem is high-rise apartments made it difficult. Okay, so high-rise apartments, because the apartments are stacked on one top of each other, the area of the panels will become less. Yes, there this problem will be there. But then still, even in high-rise apartment, at least some benefit will be there in terms of installing PV system. Wherever land is available, we can install. And definitely in the outskirts of a urban areas where the land cost is very low, definitely there is a case. And then in fact, in places like deserts, where the land is useless, so there a huge amount of rooftop systems can be installed. So again, this is your consider this as your homework again. Search for major solar plants in India and of course around the world. Huge amounts of solar panels have been coming up all over the world. So just be aware of this particular revolution which is going on around the world. Major investments is going in solar. So with that, I would like to conclude today. So let's meet in the next class.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.